Hi, I'm Danica McKellar, author of Do Not Open This Math Book. It's full of fun and easy ways for kids to understand addition and subtraction. Because let's face it, some of the new methods being taught in today's classrooms can be confusing. But we're going to clear it right up and have a great time doing it. Mr. Mouse, are you ready for story time?
Story time? I'm not tired. I don't want to go to bed yet.
Not that kind of story time. I'm going to tell you a story that makes place value really easy to learn.
Place value? That sounds scary. Maybe bedtime is in order.
Just listen, I think you'll like my friends Lynn and Larry. They make food.
I'm listening.
Once upon a time, a baker named Lynn made hot toasty buns for people to eat. Mm. Her twin brother Larry helped too. Everybody loved the buns, so Lynn made more and more. Larry had a hard time counting them and carrying them. Then they got a great idea to use tins, which really helped. You see, all the tins were the same size, and they always held 10 buns each. So instead of having to count 10 buns like this, they could instead fill up a tin and ta-da! They knew for sure there were 10 buns inside without even having to count. Wow, so much easier. So if someone ordered 14 buns, Lynn could just fill up a tin and then add 4 more like this. Or if someone ordered 21 buns, Lynn would just give them 2 full tins and 1 extra bun because 20 plus 1 is 21. Notice that since there are 10 buns in each tin, we also know that 2 tins are the same as 20 buns, 3 tins are the same as 30 buns, and 4 tins is the same as 40 buns. Can you see the pattern? How many buns are in 5 tins? Yep, 50 buns. Can you figure out the rest? Pause the video and say them out loud. Not so bad, right? Now at some point, you'll learn about place value in school. You've got the ones place, the tens place. Well, I'm gonna tell you a secret. Tins and buns are like tens and ones. Instead of a tins place, we have a tens place. And instead of a buns place, we have a ones place. Tins and buns, or tens and ones, it all works exactly the same way. For more practice, try this. Take 2 clean, empty egg cartons, have a grown-up cut off 2 sections from each so they look like tins with 10 sections each. Then use coins or other small objects or toys and make up your own addition and subtraction problems. For example, we can turn 9 plus 6 into a really easy problem by just moving one object to fill a tin. Now it's 10 plus 5, which is 15, and that means 9 plus 6 is also 15.
Wait, that was fun. We were doing math the whole time?
Yes, we were. And there are many more tips and tricks where that came from in my book.
I admit, I do like filling tins and emptying them too. What is this, boysenberry?
With you, it's all about the food, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, as long as you're learning math too, yeah? Remember to check out the other videos in this series. They're full of great tips and tricks right from Do Not Open This Math Book.